And on the same day was the Sabbath.
All right. Now we can preach the whole message off that. We're going to
We're getting a little digging down where it is. All right. And the Jews therefore said unto him that was cured, it is the Sabbath day, it is not lawful for thee to carry thy bed. And he answered them, he that made me whole, the same said unto me, take up thy bed. He got a testimony. Just like that. One little talk. You want something from Jesus?
No, no.
Just one little talk. One little talk. One little proverbial kicking the crutch out of the way.
All right.
And he had a testimony. He said, he answered and said, he that made me whole, he that healed me, he that made me different than I was that day. I didn't go to the pool and leave the same way. Jesus said, I know you've been here a long time. Wilt thou be? Are you tired of laying? Well, I'm not tired enough because I still got room for all these excuses.
All right.
I'm not that tired.
Yes, sir.
I'm not that tired because I still got energy for excuses. I still got energy to tell them, oh, I can't. I won't. I can't. This one won't. And we say, oh, that's not us. Are you human?
All right.
Are you human? It was, oh, I ride the wave of faith. Good for you. Because sometimes the wave has to come back to the shore.
Yes, sir.
The way a wave works, it goes up, and you ride the wave, and it goes back down.
Uh-huh.
People say, I remember one pastor said, what do you say if you're riding on the crest? Stay up there.
All right.
Yeah, if you're on the zenith, just stay up there. Because it's going to come down.
Yes, sir.
They'll say, what goes up must come down.
Yes, sir.
Right. Well, we're going to go back to that original text. I'm not going to try and keep you long. But I feel like God wants to do something for somebody. If they would just ignore the naysayer in their ear.
All right.
The enemy. The devil. Whether it be the family member, the devil, a demon. I have news for everyone. If everyone in this room doesn't know, the devil is not on my presence. The devil cannot be everywhere at one time.
No, he is not.
That's only an attribute that God has.
Right.
Now, he has lots of little demons and imps and all that that go out and wander around, but not the devil himself. He's only at one place at one time. That's a fact. You might feel like the devil's chasing you around, but this one of you is probably imps, little workers.
Yeah.
What we call them? Spirits. They're spirits. But it says, oh, clap your hands, oh, ye people, shout unto God with a voice of triumph.
All right.
Oh, clap your hands, all ye people, and shout unto God with the voice of triumph. And then you skip down and it says, for God is the King of all the earth. Sing ye praises with understanding.
All right.
Now, if you want something from God, you have to understand what it is you do when you praise Him.
Amen.
You step past all the halt. You step past all the lame. You step past all the crippled. You step past all the excuses.
Yes,
you step past all the crutches. And you step right into, will thou be made whole?
Amen.
When you praise the Lord, I'm talking about a Lord that sees our infirmities.
Yes,
he sees how long we lay there.
Yes.
He knows our condition better than we know our condition.
Yes,
and he said, rise up and walk.
Come on.
Even though you have 1,000 excuses, rise up, and walk. Take up thy bed and walk.
Yes, sir.
He's talking to somebody today. I don't know. Like I said, I don't know anyone's circumstances. I don't want to know after church. And I'm not saying that in a mean way. I just don't want to know. That's his job. My job is just to come preach and go back to church.
Amen.
Hope the Holy Ghost moves on somebody.
Yes, sir.
Like I said, my wife comes and says, it's easy to step in here in the anointing. She just leaves it here. Home church, I do the same thing. Like my wife comes in, so I can step into her anointing and we can go on with it. It is good to have a healthy.
It is.
good to have a helper. Amen. There is a story, I'm going to read through this story real quick. You follow along or not follow along. But it says, there's a man named Paul and a man named Silas. I don't know if you guys have ever heard this story before, but it is a great story when you're trying to understand what it means to praise the Lord. It is a great story to know when a situation seems dire, when a situation seems like there's no way that God could step in and move on it, when there's no way that God could come walking on the scene. And I know people think, oh, you're a preacher. You got it all together. You've always been a preacher. No, I'm a convict.
All right.
Oh. I'm a convict. Anyone want to know what a convict is? A convict is someone who spent time, not at the boys' home, not at the juvenile detention center, not at the county jail.
Yeah.
He spent time, a convict is someone who spent time in the penitentiary.
All right.
One of the roughest places in the world to go is the Texas penitentiary system.
Sir.
If you want to know how bad life can get, go to the Texas penitentiary.
All right.
And if you're not at rock bottom when you get there, and I'm not talking about the people that were laying at the pool, it doesn't say they were all Jews.
No.
It doesn't say they were all a chosen sect.
No.
It doesn't say that he had more sympathy or more mercy or more grace on this one.
No,
it says all of them laid there.
Yes, sir.
But I was locked up for 2 years straight. Now, I'm not saying this to brag on me, but I've been locked up in every Dallas County jail that there is. The fact, my kid is trying to get there. I told him the other day, didn't I? I told him, his name is Josh. Y'all pray for Josh. I told Josh, I said, you keep it up, you're going to visit just as many jails as I have. That's what he said. Lord, help me, I hope not. I said, well, you still got a ways to go, son, but you need to get it together. Because they're all too happy to take you to jail. They are. And if they didn't take me to jail, it wasn't their fault. I'm not here to say, well, all of them, I was wrong. I was wrong, brother. Every single time I was wrong. They just had it out for me. They had it out for me. They came and they were happy to take me. Numerous times. And it's a sad thing, but it's a testimony what God can do. He can bring you from that. I can drive into downtown Dallas and I tell my wife, That's the only jail I haven't been in. The only reason why? They built it after I got done going to jail. That's the only reason why I hadn't been there. It was under construction at that time. But this man named Paul and this man named Silas, it says in the book, who having received such a charge thrust them into an inner prison and made their feet fast in a stock.
Yep.
Now what they've done is they've taken this woman of divination or sorcery, and they cast the spirit out of her. She was no longer of any use to them.
Right.
If you get delivered and God does the delivering, you will be no more use to the devil. You won't be of a use to him anymore. If you get delivered from seduction, if you get delivered from heresies and from lying and backbiting and envy and strife and bitterness, if you get delivered from all that stuff, the devil doesn't have a use for you anymore.
Right.
Only God has a use for you.
All right, that's it.
And then when people say, what happened? You can say that same man that said, look at me. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God. And the prisoners heard them. You don't think people don't know what's going on in this neighborhood? You don't think they know?
Yes, they do.
They heard them. And suddenly, my wife came to me. And suddenly, there was a great earthquake. Now, what happened first? At midnight, Paul and Silas, what did they do first? Prayed. The first thing is, they prayed. The first thing the man at the pool did was get himself to the pool. Get himself into a place, a situation where God could work on. Where Jesus could do what he wanted to do. Because he'd been there a long time. Jesus said, you've been in this case. You've been in this condition long enough. Wilt thou? and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken. You want the foundations to shake? Pray first and pray second. And then get tired of sitting by the pool.
Yes, sir.
Get tired of having someone else get there before you. You got to be the first one when the water is troubled.
Amen.
Not the last one, but the first one. It's a one-on-one walk with God. If you want the Holy Ghost, you're going to get the Holy Ghost with a one-on-one talk with Jesus. You're going to start at the altar, which is prayer, which is repentance, which is believing that God can do something for you. He was at the pool because he could believe that God could do something for him. With all his excuses, he still believed. He still believed that Jesus could.
All right.
Jesus walked on the scene and said, you've been here long enough. I'm tired of seeing you by the pool. I'm tired of seeing you laying there. I got to work for you somewhere else. I got to work for you somewhere else. Not by the pool with excuses, but somewhere else testifying for me.
All right.
The foundations of the prison. And immediately all the doors were open and everyone's bands were loosed from two people. From two people's prayers. From two people's prayers. Just two people. It doesn't say that all of them prayed. It says all of them heard. It says two of them were praying. It said all of them were hearing, but only two of them were praying. And the foundations of the prison were shaken.
All right.
And immediately all the doors were open. And everyone's hands were loosed because two people decided they were sick of being bound down. For two people that said they were sick of being in chains upon
us.
For two people that said, I don't want to be in prison anymore. I don't want to be locked down anymore. I don't want to be in the inner prison anymore. I don't care how many doors it takes to get out. Jesus, shake the foundations today. Shake the foundations of this prison today. Let the people that heard it be the same people that walk out the door. Let those same people get a little taste of how good you are, Jesus. For two people. And at midnight, they prayed and they sang praises unto the Lord. They understood that if they prayed and they praised, what could happen? They understood it that day. They knew the story of the man at the pool of Bethesda. They knew that story. They knew what Jesus could do if he walked on the scene. They knew the power that came with them.
Amen.
They knew that power. People say, oh, you shouldn't brag about the Holy Ghost. Exactly. Don't brag about us. But brag on how good this spirit is that dwells within us. Because this spirit is the greatest thing ever. When you have this spirit dwelling within you and you praise, you have a one-on-one red line to Jesus. When you get this spirit down inside you, you can praise and you can pray and you can connect with God. And God will come running down to you. And he'll shake the foundations of your life. And he'll say, how long? How long? When he says that, he means, aren't you tired of? Aren't you sick of laying by the pool? Don't wait for the water. You be the first one to get to the water. Take up your bed and walk. Get up on the inside and walk. For two people. It's not midnight, but if someone wants to pray, then pray and bring God down. Because Jesus is already watching. It says, I've seen you've been in this case for a long time. You've been in this condition for a long time. Oh, I have, Jesus. But listen to what I got to tell you. Jesus, step right past you. I don't care where you've been. I don't care what you've done. All I want to know is where you end up today. All I want to know is, where are you now? An altar of repentance is a good place to start.
Yes, sir.
In fact, it's the only I can't forgive you of any sin.
No, sir.
Your pastor can't forgive you of any sin. That's God's business. And that's between you and God.
Amen.
You've fallen all to repentance.
Yes, sir.
That is the praying and praising that Paul and Silas, same type.
Yeah.
Different circumstances, same type. They brought God out of the sea.
Yes, sir.
Enough to shake the foundation. And the keeper of the prison, awaking out of his sleep and seeing the prison doors open, he threw out his sword and would have killed himself, supposing that the prisoners had fled. But I want to see something here interesting. There isn't one of them that left. They all wanted to see what was going to happen next.
Yes,
they said the pool's been troubled.
Hello.
It's been troubled. The floor's been shaken.
Yeah.
The door's been opened.
Hello.
Everyone is loose. Hello. Let's see what's going to happen next.
Yes.
Let's see what God's going to do next.
Yes.
Let's see how great he's going to be.
Hello.
Let him top this.
Yes.
But somebody doesn't want that. They'd rather sit by the pool. That someone walked in the door a long time ago.
Come on.
That someone walked in a long time ago.
That's right.
Jesus walked on the scene a long time ago.
Right.
Jesus walked in and said, how long?
How long?
Wilt thou? But Paul cried with a loud voice, saying, do thyself no harm, for we are all here. There isn't none of us left.
Come on.
They want to see we're going to have church.
Yeah.
We're going to see. They want to hear a message.
Come on.
He said, what's it take to be saved?
Yeah.
He says, you've got to be baptized in Jesus' name.
Come on.
You got to be filled with this power that
yeah.
I have. The power of the Holy Ghost is what shook that place.
Amen.
It wasn't their power. It wasn't Paul and Silas' power.
Right.
They're a vessel that God used.
Come on.
His spirit was there.
Come on.
They will receive power. Power. People are I want power. I want to have the authority.
Yeah,
can't do it.
Yeah,
can't do it.
Yeah.
Bring them out, said sirs. What must I do to be saved? I don't read anywhere where he preached the message. I don't read anywhere where he said what Peter said. I don't read anywhere where any of that happened. But what were they saying as they were praying? What were they saying is they were praising. Were they saying, thank God for the Holy Ghost. Thank you for your spirit. I praise you, Jesus, even in my bonds. I praise you, Jesus, even in my fetters. I praise you, Jesus, even though I'm locked up in this prison. I praise you, Jesus, even though there's door after door after door locked between me and the outside world. I praise you, Jesus, for saving me. I praise you, Jesus, for your gospel. I praise you, Jesus, for just being Jesus. I praise you for making me whole. I praise you for listening to my excuses and stepping right on by them and still making me whole. I praise you for being God Almighty. I praise you for being God robed in the flesh. We don't know what they said, but something made him say, what must we do to be saved? Something brought that idea to their head. And they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved in thy house. And they spake unto him the word of the Lord, and to all that were in his house. Now the revival moved from prison to his house. He wanted to take it home. He wanted to say, this is so good. I gotta tell my family about it. This is so great. This happened to us in prison. We were bound down. We were locked up in chains. But this is what God did. Come on, let me tell you about it. Come on, mama. Come on, daddy. Come on, sister. Come on, mama. Let me tell you about it. And they were all in his house. And he took them the same hour of the night to wash their stripes. He and all his.
All right.
The jailer's testimony. The Philippian jailer's testimony. Say, who knows how many?
All right.
Because of two men. Two men. The same praises.
All right.
And pray.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Would you stand?
My heart was like a house. One day I let the Savior in. There were many rooms.
These altars are open if you want to come repent.
Where we would visit now and then. But then one day he saw that door. I knew the day had come too soon. I said, Jesus, I'm not ready for us to visit in that room. 'Cause that's a place in my heart where even I won't go. I have some things hidden there that I don't want no one to know. But he handed me the key with tears of love on his face. He said, I want to make you clean. Let me go in your secret place. So I opened up the door, and as the two of us walked in, I was so ashamed.
How long are you going to stay?
His light revealed my hidden sin. But when I think about that room now, I'm not afraid anymore, because I know that hidden sin no longer hides behind that door. There was a place in my heart where even I wouldn't go. I had some things hidden there that I didn't want no one to know. But he handed me the key with tears of love on his face. He said, I want to make you clean. Let me go in your secret place. My heart was like a house. One day I let the Savior in. And there were many rooms where we would be. Door. I knew the day had come too soon. I said, Jesus, I'm not ready. Oh, Jesus, for us to visit in that room.
Oh, God, let's wait. All this begin to talk to the
Lord.
The
place it? In my heart.
Wonder how long you're going to stay in your condition. I wonder how long that you're going to stay in your condition.
I have some things hidden there that I didn't want no one to know. But he handed me the
key. How long are you going to let it go on?
With tears of love on his face. Oh, he said, I want to make you clean. Let me go in your secret place, 'cause that's a place in my heart where even I won't go. Jesus, have your way. I have some things hidden there that I don't want no one to know. But he handed me the with tears of love on his face. Oh. in your secret place.
I don't know how long have you been in your situation. Sometimes your midnight hour is not a time. It's not a time on the clock. Sometimes your midnight hour can be in the middle of the day at 3 o'clock. Sometimes your midnight hour is when you don't know what you're going to do. Your children have drove you crazy. And you don't know what to do. Your husband, your wife, your girlfriend, your boyfriend, whatever y'all have. You've got to be a place where you ain't sure which way is up or down. Your midnight hour is not designated by the clock. Some people's midnight hours last for months, weeks. Some of them for 38 years. But the Bible says, weeping shall endure for the night, but joy comes in the morning. And that's depending on you. How long do you want to wait? How long do you want to go through? I don't like what I'm going through, Pastor. You've been scared. You've been facing. You've been naked. But some people like to lay on the couch. They like the sympathy. They like people to feel sorry for them. They enjoy that because they get attention that way. And I'm telling you, when you get sick and tired of your situation,